In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. Today is the feast day of Pentecost. Today is a very important day in the church life in general and in our life in particular. Today is the feast day of Pentecost when our Lord Jesus Christ fulfilled his promise. As he said, I will pray to the Father and he will give you another helper that he may abide with you forever. John chapter 14, verse 10. As of today, our Lord Jesus Christ established his church on earth. But because of this great occasion, our Mother Church sent us a wonderful good news, add to the celebration of this beautiful day. The Holy Synod, led by His Holiness Pope Tawadros II, reveal and announce clearly that they consider the late Pope Cyrillus VI one of the saints of our church. Not only that, also with His Holiness Pope Cyrillus VI, they also recognize and canonize Archdeacon Habib Girgis, also to be official saint in the church. This is very good news. Amba Rafael, the General Secretary of the Holy Senate, said, to reveal that Pope Cyrillus is one of the great saints in our church, it is natural reaction of all the people in the church all over the world. During his life and after he passed away, and all these years, and this is what we expect. About Archdeacon Habib Girgis, maybe some of you who you don't know him, he is the great person, he is just Archdeacon. But he was a great, he is the main reason of the revival of the Coptic Orthodox Church in the 20th century. One time, His Holiness Pope Shenouda III said about Archdeacon Habib Girgis. In fact, he said it on the 40th anniversary of his departure, 40th day. He said, in the beginning, was darkness on the surface of the earth. And God said, let it be light, and the light was Archdeacon Habib Girgis. I'm very proud that the Holy Synod add to our celebration of the Feast of Pentecost this great news. In our local level, and then it's going to be all over the world also today, we are going to celebrate the opening of the museum of His Holiness Pope Shenouda III. God rest his soul in good memory. And also the honorary name of McCreary Road to be Pope Shenouda III Street. It's a wonderful occasion to live and to witness and to feel the beautiful day of Pentecost and all what is connected with. As I said, our Lord Jesus Christ fulfilled his promise when he said to his disciple, I will pray to the Father and he will give you another helper that he may abide with you forever. Also, our Lord Jesus Christ, before the ascension, he said, John truly baptized you with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. Not many days from now. And this had been fulfilled 10 days later, as of today, the day of Pentecost. Also, our Lord Jesus Christ said to his disciples before his ascension, "Don't leave Jerusalem until you receive the power from on high. And when you receive the power from on high, you are going to be my witness in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the end of the world." This is why we consider this particular day is the establishment of the church on earth. So let us talk a little bit about the Holy Spirit. The Lord fulfilled his promise. He sent the Holy Spirit as of today. As we believe in one God, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the third person of the Holy Trinity, co-equal with God the Father and God the Son. So the Holy Spirit is God. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God the Father and is the Spirit of God the Son. So we can say the Holy Spirit is God with all the attributes of deity. Today also I would like to answer one question. Why did God send the Holy Spirit? Why did God send the Holy Spirit? The Holy Spirit came to glorify Christ and to lead the believers into all the truth. As also our Lord Jesus Christ said to his disciples in John chapter 16, verse 13 and verse 14. When he, the Holy Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will tell you things to come. He will glorify me, said the Lord, for he will take of what is mine and declare to you. This is three main reasons why the Lord sent the Holy Spirit. From these two verses, we know that God sent the Holy Spirit because to guide us to all the truth. The Holy Spirit will tell us something or thing to come, and the Holy Spirit will glorify Christ in us. This is not only the main three reasons that the Lord sent the Holy Spirit, but the Holy Spirit came to enable us to know Christ through a new birth and to give us the power to live and to share the abundant life which Christ promised to all of us, to all those who trust him and all those who obeyed him. Not only that, our Lord sent the Holy Spirit to us to inspire us, to explain to us and reveal to us all what he taught us, to remind us about his teaching and about the truth and how we can practice the spiritual life. The Holy Spirit and the Holy Scriptures, this is very important. The Holy Spirit inspired the holy men of God to write the Holy Scriptures. Without the Holy Scripture, we cannot have the Bible. Listen carefully to what St. Peter said in his second epistle, verse 20 and verse 21. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of Scripture is of any private interpretation, for prophecy never come by the will of man, but holy men of God spoke as they were moved by the Holy Spirit, as they were inspired by the Holy Spirit. لم تأتي نبوة قط بمشيئة إنسان بل تكلم أناس الله القديسين مسوقين من الروح القدس. This is we add why our Lord sent the Holy Spirit. This is for those who wrote the Holy Bible in the Old Testament as well as in the New Testament. They all were inspired by the Holy Spirit. As for us, the Holy Spirit makes the Word of God manifested in us. The Holy Spirit makes the Word of God meaningful for us. When we read the Holy Spirit, when we read the Holy Scriptures, the Holy Spirit leads us to understand and to practice what God wants us to practice. In fact, we cannot live the holy life, the spiritual life, without the help and inspiration of the Holy Spirit. We cannot have whatsoever any relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ without the power of the Holy Spirit. We cannot have whatsoever spiritual life without the Holy Spirit. For St. Paul said to us, the fruits of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. These nine of the fruits of the Spirit, this is the spiritual life. The spiritual life is to have love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. This is the spiritual life. So if these are the fruits of the fruits of the Spirit in us, so we cannot have the fruits without the power, the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. This is a very important day in our life. In fact, it is impossible to even know Christ apart from the Holy Spirit. As he said, he will reveal to you what I taught you. As he said today, and I mentioned in the verse, that he will take whatever is mine and declare it to you. This is the Holy Spirit. Let me conclude by saying, it is impossible for us to become Christian, this is number one, to understand the Holy Bible, number two, number three, and the other spiritual truths. Number four, it is impossible for us to pray, and it is impossible for us to be witness for the Lord and to share the good news without the power and inspiration of the Holy Spirit. I don't know, many people talk about God the Father and it is great, and talk about God the Son, it is marvelous, and less people talk about God the Holy Spirit. Although, as we said in the beginning, we believe in one God, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And as I said, God the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God. It is the Spirit of God the Father, and it is the Spirit of God the Son. God the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God. God gave it to us. On this particular day, for all the believers, and we receive the power, the gifts of the Holy Spirit through the church sacraments. Briefly, in baptism, we receive the power of the Holy Spirit to get rid of the original sin and to have the birth by adoption to be the children of God. In the sacrament of Meirun, Holy Meirun, the consecration, we have been sealed by the power of the Holy Spirit. In the sacrament of Eucharist, we receive the body of Christ and the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. When the priest pray and God will descend to the Holy Spirit in the bread and the wine, and then became the holy body and the holy blood. We cannot have it without the Holy Spirit. In the sacrament of repentance and confession, we receive the power of the Holy Spirit to receive the forgiveness of our actual sin. On the anointing of the sick, we receive the power of the Holy Spirit to receive the healing, not only for our physical needs, but for our physical, our emotional, and our spiritual. In the sacrament of holy matrimony, we receive the power of the Holy Spirit to unite the two spouses, or the man and wife, to be one in Christ. And whatever God cleave together, don't let anyone put asunder. And in the sacrament of priesthood, we receive the power of the Holy Spirit to elevate the deacon to be priest, to be able to practice all the church sacraments. As I said in the beginning, today is marvelous day, the day of Pentecost. Today also is marvelous day because our mother church revealed that Pope Carolus became saint officially in our church, as well as Archdeacon Habib Girgis. And also today we are going to have and to open the Museum of His Holiness and honor the name of McCreary to be His Holiness Pope Shenouda Street. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.